How's it going, guys? Today we're going to talk about the MG42 machine gun, otherwise known as the bone saw. Now, this played a crucial role in the Second Great War, and especially for the German offensive. It was a very light machine gun, and what made it super deadly was that it was able to fire so many rounds at once. Now, Germany produced around 400,000 of the MG42s during the World War, and some of them are actually still in use as of today. In fact, dozens of militaries around the world produced many variants of this MG42 machine gun. Now, this was so intense and it had so many psychological impacts on other armies that certain departments of other armies had to create films to help relax soldiers before going into war. That's how much of an impact this gun had on the opposing side.
The MG42 made the Nazis a formidable force during World War II. American soldiers were terrified of the gun because they heard stories about how deadly the guns were. It was nicknamed Hitler's buzzsaw because, according to the National World War II Museum, it has the capability to literally cut you in half if it draws a bead on you. The War Department had to make a training video to try to persuade the new soldiers into believing that the gun had a bark worse than its bite, to convince them to be less scared. The War Department succeeded because they had enough soldiers to storm the beaches of Omaha, even though the MG42 was being used there.
What does this help us learn? Well, the creation of the MG42 machine gun displayed the importance of technological advancements during times of war. These tense periods of war are catalysts and create many new technologies and ideas. We're also able to see how much of a psychological impact periods of war have on society. And we were able to tell that competition breeds success and new ideas and technology.
The MG42 was created by the Nazis during World War II. It was a gun that made D-Day so deadly. Soldiers were bombarded by gunfire before they even got to land. According to the Historical Division of the U.S. War Department, soldiers reported hearing the fire of the guns beat on the ramps before they were lowered. Some soldiers decided to dive into the waters to try to escape getting gunned down by the machine guns. The machine guns were not only deadly, but psychologically traumatizing. The soldiers that did make it onto the beaches remained pinned down and suffered heavy losses. Colonel George A. Taylor convinced the soldiers to keep advancing despite the losses by telling them that two types of people are staying on this beach, the dead and those going to die. The soldiers had to overcome the fear that the MG42 created in order to survive and to turn the tide of World War II.